We all know where we were. If you're over 40, you remember where you were and what you were doing when you heard the news. There are moments in life when time freezes, when the clock stops. For my generation, this was that moment. 30 years later, shocked by JFK's assassination, then horrified and numb by the tragic deaths of Bobby Kennedy and Martin Luther King, we somehow became hardened to it all. Somewhere between Dallas and Vietnam and Watergate and Iran-Contra and whatever that Clinton thing was. Conspiracies became easier to believe in than our own government, but still, there were the questions.
It appears as though something has happened in the motorcade route. Something, I repeat, has happened in the motorcade route.
Hello, and welcome to Midnight in America. My name is Daniel Hopsicker, and I will be your host on a journey into the life and times of one of the most famous CIA agents that ever lived, a man by the name of Adler, Barham, and Barry Seal. We're standing on the steps of the federal courthouse in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, that were walked up and down by Barry Seal many times in the course of his illustrious career. And we're going to take a look at Barry's life, and we're going to ask a simple question. Could the scandals of the 1960s and 1970s be somehow related to the cocaine epidemic that swept America during the 1980s, an epidemic fueled in no small part by the billions of dollars worth of cocaine brought into this country by the most successful drug smuggler in American history, Barry Seal? Let's take a look. So who was Barry Seal and why is he so important? Barry Seal was the most successful drug smuggler in American history, and the cause of the MENA drug scandal, where he flew in, by the government's own estimates, over $5 billion worth of cocaine from 1981 to 1986 to fuel the go-go 80s and to fund the Contra War when the U.S. Congress would not. He is the root cause of what is today called the Clinton scandals. So, was Barry Seal, called the ghost haunting the Whitewater probe, just an extraordinarily zealous entrepreneur operating all by himself? Did the big-time players in the small backward state of Arkansas, Clinton, Vince Foster, Jackson Stevens, Jim Blair, Don Tyson, stand idly by while Seal made billions, importing tons of cocaine through MENA? Or might the goings-on in MENA, Arkansas, of Barry and the boys have been just the continuation of business as usual? In America, we've heard all about the Colombian drug lords, whose cocaine and heroin have flooded our nation. Names like Pablo Escobar, Jorge Ochoa, Carlos Lader. But there's one huge unanswered question we've never even heard asked. Who are the American drug lords? Anyone in, say, Washington, D.C.? Could Barry Seal really have been involved with everyone from Republican Attorney General Ed Meese to former Democratic National Chair Charles Manatt to current Al Gore campaign chairman Tony Coelho? And is there really a suspicious link between Barry and the boss's son, George W. Bush? To answer these questions, we're going back to the beginnings of Barry Seal's CIA career, to hear from eyewitnesses and participants who were there for this most important chapter of America's secret history. That history, in other words, in which lone gunmen play no role. Remember, of the numerous witnesses in Dealey Plaza who pointed to the grassy knoll as the place where shots came from, none were ever interviewed on the evening news until well after it no longer mattered. That won't happen with the MENA drug scandal. You're about to hear an extraordinary kind of oral history straight from the mouths of members of the tight-knit pilots fraternity of Louisiana who knew and worked with Barry Seal. While Richard Nixon was still in the White House, Professor Peter Dale Scott wrote, "A full exposure of the Watergate conspiracy will help us understand both what happened in Dallas and also the covert forces which mired America in a covert war in Southeast Asia. What links the scandal of Watergate to the assassination in Dallas is the ominous merger between U.S. intelligence networks and the forces of organized crime.